can make a speech tomorrow night.
No, I'll do a speech tomorrow night. My bride and I give our baby girl, Carolyn, to William Wayne Coase.
Thank you.
Sing a song for me.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. What fun it is to run.
See, you took a breath.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in one horse open sleigh.
Go on a horse around, one of you keep an eye out for Peggy. Go
they sound like the, they sound like the chipmunks.
Yeah.
Y'all see Peggy come and get that smile off your face. She wants to be serious.
Sugar, she's spice, she's everything nice, and she's daddy's little girl.
Well, I don't know, Peggy, you take another night.
Yeah, I'm doing this moment.
Yeah.
We got a lot of garlic. We can have this stuff come down. Out there. This looks cute. It's a
recessional. The recessional. That's all right. And then we'll turn and go out. And Joni, I think it'd be better for you to drive the maid and each move when you come to the center.
It looks a lot better. There's just one thing that happened. These two are standing. During the ceremony, are you going to be up here?
Yes.
Okay. So he will be close to you.
Yes, and he'll just keep his hand right there. We'll keep this. All right, let's have a recession, please. Amanda, you and John go out. Just try that.
Oh, what a motley crew.
I know.
Sean, you did a good job.
Yeah, there's still a slight chance for one of them, but...
Thank you.
test, nothing.
I have to do this to you.
Yeah.
I'm not going to say.
If no bill, we quit on mail, we'll focus on. Oh, boy.
And it's so tremendously important that not only are they professing their faith to each other, they come to profess their faith in Christ. And so I just want to challenge you when you come tomorrow, remember that in the spirit of which we want the ceremony to be conducted. I don't, unless it's
No, the only thing I want to do is tell the party here what how many rows down for the next one to start before you leave. I'm going to have to go back there and count them and see. I think it's going to be about 5 rows down. You want to head over?
Thank you.
Thank you.
sit quietly.
Don't play.
Where's the ring?
Right here.
Oh, shit.
Well, you guys know.
Make the dream come true. If I had only
individual personal commitment to Jesus Christ, marriage is the single most important decision a person ever makes. So for that reason, marriage should not be entered into unadvisedly or casually, but rather discreetly and soberly. We learn from the scriptures that the Lord Jesus Christ honored a wedding with his own presence. In the second chapter of John's Gospel, Jesus performed the first miracle there. Wayne and Carol both placed their faith in Jesus Christ as their personal Savior. They have established a relationship with him. They're thankful that he has given them the faith to wait upon his provision one for the other. Let's look for our Lord in prayer, shall we? Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for the beauty of this very special occasion. We want to ask you to bless this ceremony as we come together to unite in marriage this man, this woman before you. Father, we acknowledge this as a joyful celebration, and at the same time, it's a serious and solemn occasion. And so we ask you, Lord God, to bless this time. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her own God.
As Wayne and Carolyn enter into this sacred covenant of marriage, they become totally committed to each other as companions for life, a permanent relationship, one man, one woman. In Genesis chapter 2, our Lord declared that a man shall leave his father and mother and shall cleave to his wife. The two shall build a home and become one. And our Lord Jesus gives Christians an even deeper meaning, a higher beauty of marriage in Ephesians chapter 5. What we find is that the love between husband and wife is to be a reflection of the love that Jesus Christ has for us as his people. Marriage has been designed by God to bless us by providing for us the opportunity to experience an inner relationship in some measure of what we experience in our relationship with him. Wayne, as you seek to sacrificially love Carolyn, as Christ loves you, you'll give her the opportunity to taste in some limited, finite way what God's love for her is like. She'll be able to feel in her relationship with you in some measure what is true about God's unsacrificial love for her. God's love is also demonstrated to us that he has a purpose, he has a plan for our lives. And that purpose provides us with a sense of value, a sense of meaningfulness. Carolyn, if you seek to express your respect, your honor for your husband Wayne, you'll give him an opportunity to taste in some finite, limited way, in some measure, sense the meaning and purpose that God has. Through your ministry of respect and honor to your husband, you'll be able to experience a new relationship in some measure what is true about his relationship with God. He's very special to God, and his task that he has to accomplish before God is important. Wayne, as you seek to love the woman that God has given you, keep in mind that God created the woman. He took her not from man's head, lest she should rule over him, nor did God take Eve from Adam's feet, lest he should trample on her. But rather, when God created the woman, he took her from the side of the man, that she should be his equal before God. From close to his heart, he should love her, and cherish her, and protect her. Because God has created the woman to be a helper for her husband, their obligations to each other in marriage are distinctive and different. Wayne is Carolyn's husband. God has given you instructions in his word. Your highest priority in life is your obedience and your submission to the Lord Jesus Christ. Pray that you may continue to grow as a man of faithfulness before our Lord, obedient to his word, a man of grace, kindness, and compassion. Wayne, you're to be Carolyn's leader, her provider, her protector, her lover. Jesus provided the example of love by sacrificing his life for the people whom he loved. Likewise, the Lord Jesus calls upon you to love Carolyn with that same kind of sacrificial love. In Ephesians 5, we read, husbands, love your wives just as Christ also loved the church and gave himself up for her. So husbands ought also to love their own wives as their own body. He who loves his own wife loves himself. For no one ever hated his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it just as Christ does the church because we are members of his body. Wayne, are you willing to accept this responsibility before God and man, being Carolyn's husband, to honor her, serve her, love her, and sacrifice her? May God grant you wisdom in fulfilling your role as her husband, as her leader. May you always recognize her for the husband that she is, and remember that Carolyn is a gift from our Lord himself. Carolyn, your primary allegiance, like Wayne, is to your Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We pray that you may bless you and develop you into a gracious woman of God. Carolyn, your role in marriage is described in Genesis as a helper because Wayne needs your help. He needs your respect and your love and your commitment to him. The New Testament is always described by the word submission. And submission does not imply inferiority, nor does it suggest insignificance. But rather, submission involves a commitment to serve Wayne and help accomplish the task that God has discharged him. Just as Wayne is to evidence his love for you by sacrificing for you, so also you're to evidence your love for him by submitting to your leadership. God prescribes this role again in Ephesians chapter 5, where we read, "Wives, be subject to your own husbands as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ also is the head of the church, he himself being the Savior of the body. But as the church is subject to Christ, so also wives ought to be to their husbands in everything." Carolyn, do you accept your responsibility as Wayne's God-given helper when you submit to his authority and the will of Christ? May God give you a great heart to believe in the love that he provided for you.
Now, if you, knowing of nothing either legal or moral, forbid your union and marriage, wish to take its vows as soon as obligated, indicate that will be by joining the lightning. Would you, Wayne, have this woman, Carolyn, whose hand you hold, to be your wedded wife, solemnly promise that you will be unto her a loyal husband, fulfill your obligations to protect her, honor her, love her and cherish her in adversity as well as in prosperity, and keep yourself unto her alone so long as you both shall live. Would you, Carolyn, have this man, Wayne, whose hand you hold, to be your wedded husband, and solemnly promise that you will be unto him a tender, loving, and true wife through sunshine and shadow of life, and be faithful unto him so long as you both shall live? The old story that when God made a covenant with Noah, he set a bowl in the clouds, a token thereof, and said, "I will look upon it that I may remember the everlasting covenant." From this we may learn that it is well for us when we enter into solemn agreement one with another to set apart some reminder of what we have promised. As tokens of your marriage covenant, you have each selected a ring of gold. Gold, precious among metals, fittingly represents the precious vows that unite us and more. These rings, endless and broken by outside forces, are fit symbols of the unbroken partnership of marriage, which should be continued until broken by death. Let them be unto you constant reminders of your obligations to each other, and mute incentives to their fulfillment. For as much as the husband takes the wife into his care, hearts to her his name, Wayne, I give you that ring, place it upon the wedding finger of your bride. And say unto her these words, "I, Wayne, give this ring to you, Carolyn, and by this act declare, in the presence of these witnesses, that I take you to be my beloved wife, that I will be unto you a faithful husband until death departs. I make this vow in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit." Carolyn, take the ring you have selected. Place it upon the wedding finger of your bride. And say unto him these words, "I, Carolyn, give this ring to you, Wayne, and thus declare, in the presence of these witnesses, that you are the husband you will notice to my right that there are two individual candles. Those individual candles represent your life up until this afternoon. I'm going to ask you to go and pick those individual candles to light the single candle, which will represent your life from this afternoon forward. Extinguish your individual candle and come.
By joining hands, I, the minister of Christ,
want you to say to each other this word from the Bible. Entreat me not to leave or to return from following. For where you go, I will go. Where you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people. And your God, my God. Would you please bow for the singing of the Lord's Prayer?
Thank you. Thank you. tie that marriage this man and this woman before you. Father, we acknowledge this is a joyful celebration, and at the same time, it's a serious and solemn occasion. So we ask, Lord God, to bless this time in Jesus' name.
Is this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
For you, so also you're to evidence your love for him by submitting to his leadership. God prescribes this role again in Ephesians chapter 5, where we read, "Wives, be subject to your own husbands as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ also is the head of the church, he himself being the Savior of the body. But as the church is subject to Christ, so also wives ought to be to their husbands in everything." Carolyn, do you accept your responsibility as Wayne's God-given helper? Will you submit to his authority and obedience to Christ? And may God give you a thankful heart for the leader and the love he has provided for you.
And now, if you, knowing of nothing either legal or moral, to forbid your union in marriage, wish to take its vows and assume its obligation, indicate that wish by joining the right hand. Will you, Wayne, have this woman, Carolyn, whose hand you hold, to be your wedded wife, solemnly promise that you will be unto her a loyal husband, fulfill your obligations to protect her, honor her, love her and cherish her in adversity as well as in prosperity, and keep yourself unto her alone so long as you both shall live. Will you, Carolyn, have this man, Wayne, whose hand you hold, to be your wedded husband, and solemnly promise that you will be unto him a tender, loving, and true wife through sunshine and shadow life, and be faithful unto him so long as you both shall live. We read in the old story that when God made a covenant with Noah, he set a bow in the cloud as a token thereof and said, "I will look upon it that I may remember the everlasting covenant." From this we may learn that it is well for us when we enter into solemn agreement one with another to set apart some reminder of what we have promised. As tokens of your marriage covenant, you have each selected a ring of gold. Gold, precious among metals, fittingly represents the precious ties that unite husband and wife. These rings, endless until broken by outside forces, are fit symbols of the unbroken partnership of marriage, which should be continued until broken by death. Let them be unto you constant reminders of your obligations to each other, and mute incentives to their fulfillment. For as much as the husband takes the wife into his care, hearts to her his name, Wayne, I give you that ring. Place it upon the wedding finger of your bride. And say unto her these words: "I, Wayne, give this ring to you, Carolyn, and by this act declare, in the presence of these witnesses, that I take you to be my beloved wife, that I will be unto you a faithful husband until death shall part us. I make this vow in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit." Carolyn, take the ring you have selected. Place it upon the wedding finger of your bride. And say unto him these words: "I, Carolyn, give this ring to you, Wayne, and thus declare, in the presence of these witnesses, that you are the husband of my choice, that I will be faithful to you until death shall part us. I make this vow in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit." Thus you're to wear these rings as the enclosing bond of reverence and trust. You both are to fulfill the perfect circle of beauty that makes you one. Now, you will notice to my right that there are two individual candles lit. Those individual candles represent your life up until this afternoon. I'm going to ask you to go and take those individual candles to light the single candle, which will represent your life from this afternoon forward. extinguish your individual candle and come and stand.
Word or deed of yours shall cloud her brow with grief.
dim her eyes with tears. Carolyn, I charge you before God and these witnesses, strive to retain by your virtue this heart you have won by your graces. And I charge you, both, let not your eyes forget the gentle gray they wore in courtship's smiling day, so you will find in your union an unfailing source of joy, being one in name, one in name, and one in happy destiny together. I want you to join hands facing each other. I want you to say to each other, this word are to return from following you. For where you go, I will go. Where you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people. And your God, my God. Would you please bow for the singing of the Lord's Prayer?
Lord, when it be. safety in her shack.
Oh, yeah,
you look so handsome.
Oh, yeah.
He had to make sure he was on that.
He had to make sure he was on that tag.
Well, that's what everybody told him. Just a little bit.
just hit the red button again there.
Anyway,
good one, Ed. Stay there until the window. I can't believe Ed did that to his keys. That was terrible.
This. Nothing. I didn't do this. Although it's funny, I didn't do it.
There's a shame stuff back.
Yeah. Is that the part you wrote on there, Lisa?
No, I wrote this book. Oh, please, sorry, please. I'm just kidding.
Coming.
Friendship just goes so far.
Yeah.
I guess they're coming.
Come on out this way and go down.
I'm going to bring the truck down, he said.
I can't. Too full of garbage.
That's not the reason.
Too full of stuff.
They
gave you the keys down there. Come on, Wayne.
You're not going all the way down there.
Come on, now. You can't back out now.
Come on.
He's fighting.
You need to come now or I'm sticking the keys in the ground and you can pour them on yourself.
Come on.
You got to come.
I'm going to give you a question.
Well, let's go, girl.
Your battery pack.
This side, Wayne.
Yeah, what's the difference?
Oh, yeah, Wayne.
Wayne, your keys are on the hood. Wayne, Ed.
Grossness.
Yeah.
Oh, Ed did a number on the keys.
Yeah.
Ed!
No!
Did you have to say you came in
them? Yeah. Fun now. Oh God, those are the keys. That's terrible.
Fair water hose.
You washed off the car.
What's going on with
that? I gotta use it.
Here.
Ed, what you got there, man?
Flyer.
He's underneath you. Your jacket. Man,
I need a drop piece. Slippery.
I can't. They're electric. Where's Wayne?
Went to wash the keys. He'll be back.
Thought you weren't gonna let him do anything to the inside.
Carol. I couldn't believe somebody did something like that.
Off,
yeah.
later.
Bye.
Yeah. hold marriage in high respect and esteem. And apart from a person's individual, personal commitment to Jesus Christ, marriage is the single most important decision that a person ever makes. And so for that reason, marriage should not be entered into unadvisedly or casually, but rather discreetly and soberly. We learn from the Scriptures that the Lord Jesus Christ honored a wedding with His own presence in the second chapter of John's Gospel when Jesus performed His first miracle there. Wayne and Carolyn both placed their faith in Jesus Christ as their personal Savior. They have established a relationship with Him. And they're thankful that He has given them the faith to wait upon His provision one for the other. Let's look to our Lord in prayer, shall we? Heavenly Father, we want to thank You for the beauty of this very special occasion. We want to ask You to bless this ceremony as we come together to unite in marriage this man and this woman before You. Father, we acknowledge this is a joyful celebration, and at the same time, it's a serious and solemn occasion. And so we ask You, Lord God, to bless this time in Jesus' name. Amen. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I.
When Carolyn enter into this sacred covenant of marriage, they become totally committed to each other as companions for life in a permanent relationship of one man and one woman. In Genesis chapter 2, our Lord declared that the man shall leave his father and mother and shall cleave to his wife, and the two shall build a home and become one. And our Lord Jesus gives Christians an even deeper meaning and a higher beauty of marriage in Ephesians chapter 5. What we find is that the love between husband and wife is to be a reflection of the love that Jesus Christ has for us as His people. Marriage has been designed by God to bless us by providing for us the opportunity to experience in a human relationship in some measure of what we experience in our relationship with Him. Wayne, as you seek to sacrificially love Carolyn as Christ loves you, you'll give her the opportunity to taste in some limited, finite way what God's love for her is like. She'll be able to feel in her relationship with you in some measure what is true about God's own sacrificial love for her. And God's love is also demonstrated to us in that He has a purpose, He has a plan for our lives. And that purpose provides us with a sense of value, a sense of meaningfulness. Carolyn, as you seek to express your respect and your honor to your husband, Wayne, you'll give him an opportunity to taste in some finite, limited way, in some measure, a sense of the meaning and purpose that God has for him. Through your ministry of respect and honor to your husband, you'll be able to experience in human relationship in some measure what is true about him, his relationship with God. He's very special to God, and his task that he has to accomplish before God is important. Wayne, as you seek to love the woman that God has given you, keep in mind that when God created the woman, He took her not from man's head, lest she should rule over him, nor did God take Eve from Adam's feet, lest he should trample on her. But rather, when God created the woman, He took her from the side of the man, that she should be His equal before God. From close to His heart, He should love her and cherish her and protect her. Because God has created the woman to be a helper for her husband, their obligations to each other in marriage are distinctive and different. Wayne is Carolyn's husband. God has given you instructions in His Word. Your highest priority in life is your obedience and your submission to the Lord Jesus Christ. Pray that you may continue to grow as a man of faithfulness before our Lord, obedient to His Word, a man of grace and kindness and compassion. Wayne, you're to be Carolyn's leader, her provider, her protector, and her lover. Jesus provided the example of love by sacrificing His life for the people whom He loved. And likewise, the Lord Jesus calls upon you to love Carolyn with that same kind of sacrificial love. In Ephesians 5, we read, "Husbands, love your wives just as Christ also loved the church and gave Himself up for her. So husbands ought also to love their own wives as their own body. He who loves his own wife loves himself. For no one ever hated his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it just as Christ does the church, because we are members of His body." Wayne, are you willing to accept this responsibility before God and man, being Carolyn's husband, to honor her, serve her, love her, and sacrifice for her? God grant you wisdom in fulfilling your role as her husband, as her leader. May you always recognize her for the husband who she is, and remember that Carolyn is a gift to you from our Lord Himself. Carolyn, your primary allegiance, like Wayne, is to your Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We pray that He may bless you and develop you into a gracious woman of God. Carolyn, your role in marriage is described in Genesis as a helper because Wayne needs your help. He needs your respect and your love and your commitment to him. In the New Testament, your role is described by the word submission. And submission does not imply inferiority, nor does it suggest insignificance. But rather, submission involves your commitment to serve Wayne and help accomplish the task that God has discharged in him. Just as Wayne is to evidence his love for you by sacrificing for you, so also you're to evidence your love for him by submitting to his leadership. God prescribes this role again in Ephesians chapter 5, where we read, "Wives, be subject to your own husbands as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ also is the head of the church, He Himself being the Savior of the body. But as the church is subject to Christ, so also wives ought to be to their husbands in everything." Carolyn, do you accept your responsibility as Wayne's God-given helper? And will you submit to his authority and obedience to Christ? And may God give you a thankful heart for the leader and the love that He has provided to you.
And now, if you, knowing of nothing either legal or moral, can forbid your union in marriage, wish to take its vows and assume its obligation, indicate that wish by joining the right hand. Will you, Wayne, have this woman, Carolyn, whose hand you hold, to be your wedded wife? Solemnly promise that you will be unto her a loyal husband and fulfill your obligations to protect her, honor her, love her, and cherish her in adversity as well as in prosperity, and keep yourself unto her alone so long as you both shall live. Will you, Carolyn, have this man Wayne, whose hand you hold, to be your wedded husband, solemnly promise that you will be unto him a tender, loving, and true wife through sunshine and shadow life, and be faithful unto him so long as you both shall live. We read in the old story that when God made a covenant with Noah, he set a bull in the cloud as a token thereof and said, "I will look upon it that I may remember the everlasting covenant." From this we may learn that it is well for us when we enter into solemn agreement one with another to set apart some reminder of what we have promised. As tokens of your marriage covenant, you have each selected a ring of gold. Gold, precious among metals, fittingly represents the precious ties that unite husband and wife. These rings, endless until broken by outside forces, are fit symbols of the unbroken partnership of marriage, which should be continued until broken by death. Let them be unto you constant reminders of your obligations to each other and mute incentives to their fulfillment. For as much as the husband takes the wife into his care and keeping, imparts to her his name, Wayne, I give you that ring. Place it upon the wedding finger of your bride. And say unto her these words, "I, Wayne, give this ring to you, Carolyn. And by this act declare, in the presence of these witnesses, that I take you to be my beloved wife, that I will be unto you a faithful husband until death shall part us. I make this vow in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Carol, take the ring you have selected. Place it upon the wedding finger of your bride. And say unto him these words, I, Carol, give this ring to you, Wayne, and thus declare in the presence of these witnesses that you are the husband of my choice, that I will be faithful to you until death shall part us. I make this vow in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Thus you're to wear these rings as the enclosing bond of reverence and trust. You both are to fulfill the perfect circle of beauty that makes you one. Now, you will notice to my right that there are two individual candles lit. Those individual candles represent your lives up until this afternoon. I'm going to ask you to go and take those individual candles to light the single candle, which will represent your life from this afternoon forward. Extinguish your individual candle and come and stand before. Life, I charge you to be true to the vows you have taken. With your marriage, you begin life under new conditions and larger responsibilities. It is only by faithfully performing the duties and fulfilling the obligations of your relationship that true and lasting happiness can be found. For as much as you, Wayne, and you, Carolyn, have openly declared your wishes to be united in marriage, and in the presence of God and before these witnesses have pledged love and fidelity each to the other, and have confirmed the same by each giving and receiving a ring, and by joining hands, I, as a minister of Christ's Church, legally authorized so to do by the state of Texas, pronounce that you are husband and wife. Wayne, I charge you before God and these witnesses. You're to guard well Carolyn, who now commits herself to your keeping, and strive so to live that no word or deed of yours shall cloud her brow with grief or dim her eyes. And Carolyn, I charge you before God and these witnesses, strive to retain by your virtues this heart you have won by your grace. And I charge both of you, let not your eyes forget the gentle ray they wore in courtship's smiling day, so you will find in your union an unfailing source of joy, being one in name, one in happy destiny together. Now I want you to join hands facing each other. I want you to say to each other this word from the Bible. Entreat me not to leave you, or to return from following you. For where you go, I will go. Where you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people, and your God, my God. Would you please bow for the singing of the Lord's Prayer?
Temptation, but deliver us from evil. in church pews, if you remember. Now, same with his.
Ready? One, two.
Thank you.
Oh, that plate's cold.
Yeah, why don't you do